بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome, our brothers in Islam, to lesson 179 of Al-Arabiyyah to Bayn Yadayk, Book 1, Part 1 of the New Version. وقفنا عند الصفحة 114. We stopped at page 114. وتحدثت عن فعل تزوج في الدرس الماضي. I spoken about the verb تزوج, he married, in the previous lesson. وهذا الفعل تزوج, يتزوج, مرادف لي, is similar to the verb, as those brothers are knowing, who are reading the Quran often, the verb نكح. إذا نكح is he married. نكح خالد خديجة. يعني خالد married خديجة. يعني ليس هنا حرف جر بعد الفعل. There is no preposition after the verb. So like we have done with تزوج, you have to place the B. تزوجت بخديجة. I married خديجة. Although the B is not compulsory with تزوجة, but you can add the B, and that's very famous. But نكح is straight away فعل ماض, past tense, فاعل subject, what is خالد, and فاعل is known with, by having a ضمة, and مفعول به خديجة. إذن نكح ينكح, he marries, إنكح marry, إنكحها marry her, نكاحا marriage. And I think the word نكاح is also very famous in Pakistan, maybe Bangladesh, India. The word nikah, عقد نكاح is a marriage certificate, or you can also call it عقد زواج. فهو ناكح, like متزوج, وهي ناكحة, والمفعول منكوح. وهذا الاسم اسم المفعول غير مشهور, is not famous. Like متزوج. Okay. وهذا الفعل موجود في القرآن. And this verb is present في القرآن الكريم, in the noble Quran. قال الله تعالى, Allah the Exalted said, ولا تنكحوا ما نكح آباؤكم من النساء. هنا نجد في آية واحدة الفعل مرتين. We find the verb two times in one ayah. Just imagine, one ayah. وَلَا تَنْكِحُوا مَا نَكَحَ آبَاؤُكُمْ. السؤال هو, the question is, أي فعل هذا وأي فعل هذا؟ Which verb is this and which verb is this? من حيث regarding أنواع الفعل, the types of verbs. So talk about the tense. Which tense is this and which tense is this? ولا تنكحوا هذا فعل مضارع. It's a present tense verb for the plural. It's normally تنكحونا, you lot marry, but the لام is here, لا الناهية, the prohibiting law. And you drop the noon after the waw, you add the silent alif. نكح, as we have just done, is a فعل ماض, past tense verb. إذن, ولا تنكحوا ما نكح آباؤكم من النساء. معنى الآية, the meaning of the ayah, and marry not women whom your father married. اوكي لحظة من فضلكم. لست بوحدي في البيت. I'm not alone at home. ولذلك and because of that أغلقت الباب. I closed the door. This ayah speaks about an evil act. It's so evil that you cannot even think about it. Okay? This ayah is warning us of a very evil, filthy act. Okay? And that is that we are not allowed to marry, and marry not women whom your father married. Okay? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed, it was a shameful and most hateful, look how Allah describes it, to marry any women that your father had married. So it's not always like, you know, the first thing you think about is your own mother, but it doesn't mean only your mother, but also the multiple wives that your father has married. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this wicked act, indeed, it was shameful and most hateful and an evil way. Okay, brothers? So don't get into the deception of a shaitan al-rajim. So the women, the second, third, fourth wife that your father marries, you should stay away from them like you stay away from the lion. Meaning with that is when it comes to marrying them, not when it comes to respecting them and honoring them and give them ikram. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about if the shaitan poisons your heart with marrying them anytime after your father dies. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وورد المصدر يعني the مصدر the noun of the verb form that is نكحة. Okay, the noun of the verb form is mentioned. So we have mentioned, I've mentioned the word نكحة in its past and present tense form in the Quran al-Karim, and now we're going to the مصدر, what is نكاح. وورد المصدر في حديث أبي موسى الأشعري. In the hadith of the companion Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, with a shadda and a kasra above the line, above the letter, below the shadda, رضي الله عنه. حيث قال, where he said, قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا نكاح إلا بولي. Two كسرة above the letter below the شدة. Here is the مصدر. هنا المصدر, مصدر الفعل نكح. So ما معنى لا نكاح إلا بولي؟ There is no nikah, there is no marriage except with the presence of a wali. Okay. والحديث رواه الترمذي ورقم الحديث 1101 وصححه الألباني رحمه الله. Then the hadith says لا نكاح, there is no nikah, there is no valid nikah except with a wali, except with a guardian, meaning that the woman cannot marry herself, okay, by herself, okay, she needs the permission of the wali, and the wali, my brothers in Islam, is the father, نعم. The wali is the father. لحظة من فضلكم. One moment please. نعم، يعني الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله mentioned that the wali in the marriage is the father as long as he is Muslim. So the wali has always to be Muslim. هذا شرط. This is a condition. The wali has to be Muslim. فإذا لم يكن هناك أب, if there is no father, أو مات الأب or the father, يعني died, أو لم يكن مسلما, or if he's not a Muslim, then it goes to the grandfather. Okay, the grandfather, from the father to the grandfather. And after the grandfather, if he, for example, there is no father and no grandfather, then it's the son of this woman that is willing to marry. And this is a situation that can only be if she has like, if she has a son. So she has the son from a previous marriage. In that situation, the son becomes a wali. So the father, if not, then her grandfather. If not, then her own son. So her own son will be a wali. Okay? But this is not the case if she has no child. Okay? And after that, it's her brother. And after that, if she has no brother, so she has no father, she has no grandfather, she has no son, then her own brother. He will be the wali. This is the order. And if she has no brother, then her uncle. Bearing in mind that all of these that I've mentioned are paternal, and it's from the father's side. So the khalun, the maternal uncle, he is not a wali. The jaddun min jihati al-ummi, the grandfather from the mother's side, is not a wali. And we're talking about always the father's side, from the father's side, my brothers in Islam. And نعم. And if she has no wali, if everybody died in and she's in a Muslim land, the Prophet said as-sultanu waliyu man la waliya lahu. As-sultanu, yani the ruler, is the wali. وَلِيُّ مَنْ لَا وَلِيَّ لَهُ, for the one who has no wali. So the government, they will be the wali, yani the ruler of the country, or his lawyer, his judges, they will be responsible for marrying her, and they will be the wali for who has no wali. But the issue is many of our brothers and sisters that are revert, they have no family members that can be a wali because they're not a Muslim, and there is no Islamic government in the countries that they are. So How can we implement in the hadith السلطان ولي من لا ولي له? In that situation, like Sheikh bin Baz said, in that situation where there is no Islamic government, where there is no, before that, there is no family members that can be wali from the father's side. In that situation, like Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah clearly stated, that al-markaz al-islami, they will be the wali of the sister. They will be the wali of the sister that want to marry. Of course, a man doesn't need a wali. A wali is only for a woman. So who's going to take care for her marriage and make the marriage valid? It's the al-markaz al-islami. Ra'is, he said, al-ra'is al-markaz al-islami, the head of the Islamic markaz in that particular country. So al-markaz al-islami, you can say it's not just a masjid. It's more than a masjid. The markaz, yani, it's like one central masjid where all the activities are, where the da'wah, mashallah, is going there, and where there are lessons. That's called a markaz al-islami. It's more than just a masjid for the five daily prayers. Okay. Sometimes in the West, you just have one markaz in the whole country. Different marakis, big marakis in each big city. So she has then to go to the ra'is, the head of the markaz al-islami, and he will be her wali, and he can also assist her in marrying a pious brother. This is something I just wanted to mention, although some of you might not find this interesting, but there might be some reverts that hearing this for the first time. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease their affairs, all of them. Then, we have in total three verbs related to marriage. We have tazawwaja, he married, nakaha, he married, okay, tazawwaja yatazawwaju, nakaha yankihu, and there is a third verb. There is a third verb mentioned in the Quran, kama warada fil Qur'ani, like mentioned in the Noble Quran, fil Qur'ani al-Karimi, fi'lun muta'addin. It's without a ya. Fi'lun muta'addin. With two kasra. Fi'lun muta'addin. What is a fi'lun muta'addin? You will learn that in the green book, inshallah. You have fi'lun lazimun, that's the verb that only needs a fa'il, a subject. And fi'lun muta'addin, that's the verb that needs a third person, that needs a maf'ulun bihi. Okay? So for example, daraba khalidun, khalid hit. You cannot stop there. You just have the fi'lun and fa'il. You need a maf'ulun bihi. What did he hit? Daraba khalidun, al-baba, the door. So there is a fi'lun muta'addin, because the two we just have done, they are a bit different than this one. So this verb, this fi'lun muta'addin is muhimmun, is important, and that's the verb zawwaja. Zawwaja. What means zawwaja? من منكم يعرف هذا الفعل? Who of you knows this verb? Zawwaja khalidun jarahu بابنته. So I think some of you know the meaning now. لأن بالمثال يتضح المقال. With an example, with giving an example, the statement becomes clear. So زوج خالد. You cannot stop there. You need a مفعول به. That is جارة. وهو مضاف. هو مضاف إليه. So زوج خالد ابنة زوج خالد جاره is he married off, okay? He gave in marriage, okay? So يعني this verb is important because it comes in the Quran, okay? زوج خالد. Khalid married off. Khalid gave in marriage. Okay. Zawwaja Khalidun. You can also say Zawwaja Khalidun. I think you can also say زوج خالد بنته بسعيد. I think you can change this to in order. Anyway, we use this order because it's the Quranic order. So زوج خالد جاره بابنته or بخديجة. خالد gave his daughter in marriage to his neighbor. زوجت خالدا ابنتي or بنتي. I gave my daughter to خالد يعني in marriage. Okay. زوجت خالدا ابنتي سعيدة. I married off. So this is an important verb, and this is something that you find in the religion of Islam, because some other people who are not Muslim, they just, you know, they're women, they just marry without having a wali, and you know, and that is, and it doesn't go like that. Okay, it's not valid in Islam. So that's why this verb has a big weight in Islam. Yani this verb is very common. Okay. من سيزوج خديجة? Who will give خديجة in marriage? Okay. أبوها طبعا. Her father, of course. زوج بنتك بخالد. Let your daughter marry or marry your daughter with خالد. يعني give your daughter in marriage to خالد. زوج. زوجها الآن. هي كبيرة في السن. She's old in age. زوجني. Make me marry. زوجني بنتك. Make me marry your daughter. This is something you can say when you knock a door of an Arabic person. You can say it in a polite way. من فضلك, please. زوجني. Make me marry. Let me marry me with your daughter. Let me, you know, my English is not that good, but the message has come, inshallah. Make me marry with your daughter. زوجني ببنتك أو ببنتك, because daughter has two ways to say it. And this is something that used to be very, very common in the time of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yani the companions, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, between them, they used to implement this verb. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave his daughter to Ali radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave two of his daughters to Uthman radiallahu anhu. Okay. Companions, friends between each other, something we rarely see today, that friends, just like normal friends, that they gave each other's daughter, they gave their daughters to the other friends. Okay, we find that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu gave his daughter Hafsa to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We find that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu gave his daughter Asma to Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam radiallahu anhu. Look, they are just friends. Okay, it doesn't mean that they are different in age, just friends. And you find that Umar, that Ali radiallahu anhu gave his daughter to Umar ibn Khattab. So these are just live examples of this thing that's happening. You find, subhanallah, brothers who are searching for marriage for 5, 6 years, 7 years, okay? And their friends, they know this, but they never came to him and said, Akhi Khalid, I have a sister. Okay, I will talk with my father. If you want, inshallah, I can, you know, I can arrange something for you, inshallah. Akhi Sa'id, I have a daughter for you. Okay, if she accepts, if she agrees with it, and you agree, then we can go forward, we can go ahead. So this is something that is, subhanallah, is not very common today. I have just heard it a very few times, maybe once, that a friend told a friend in Europe, Akhi, you know, like I have a sister, and inshallah, you know, like you're suitable, and shall arrange something, inshallah. Although the brother cannot be a wali if the father is there, okay, but he can at least be a sabab and a reason, inshallah. طيب اذا المصدر تزويجا كان التزويج عاديا. Marrying off was عاديا, was normal في وقت الصحابة, in the time of the companions رضي الله عنهم. فهو مزوج, he's the one that gives off in marriage, that marries somebody to somebody else. والمفعول مزوج. لحظة من فضلكم. إذن we have finished the derivements, and I just want to give a proof of the Quran where this this verb is mentioned. قال الله تعالى إن المتقين في مقام أمين. Verily the muttaqun will be in a place of security. في جنات وعيون, among gardens and springs. يلبسون, يلبسون من سندس وإستبرق متقابلين. Dressed in fine silk and also in thick silk, facing each other. Just imagine this picture. كذلك وزوجناهم, زوج يزوج, وزوجناهم بحور عين. وزوجناهم بحور عين. You see the B comes as well in this verb. زوج خالد سعيدا, زوج خالد سعيدا بخديجة. إذن وزوجناهم بحور عين. So it will be, and we shall marry them to حور عين. يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة آمنين. They will call therein for every kind of fruit in peace and security. لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا الموتة الأولى. ووقاهم عذاب الجحيم. They will never taste death therein except the first death, and he will save them from the torment of the blazing fire. فضلا من ربك ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. As a bounty from your Lord, that will be the supreme success. سورة الدخان الآية الواحدة والخمسون إلى الآية السابعة والخمسين. سأقف هنا إن شاء الله, وإلى درس قادم إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.